And here is the Writer's Almanac for Thursday. It's the 18th of June, 2020. It was on this day, 1815, Napoleon Bonaparte met his final defeat at the Battle of Waterloo in Belgium, leading a French army of around 69,000 troops against the Duke of Wellington and about 67,000 British, Dutch, Belgian, and German troops, with another army, the Prussian army, 48,000 strong, arriving near the end of the day. It had rained heavily the night before, so Napoleon delayed the start of the battle until midday to give the ground time to dry out, and that delay gave the Prussian army time to meet up with Wellington's forces, and it cost the French the battle. It's the birthday of the writer who said bad men make for more interesting stories. Short story writer Jean McGarry, born in Providence, Rhode Island, 1948, author of Heirs of Providence, The Courage of Girls, Ocean State, and many other books. It's the birthday of the author and psychotherapist Amy Bloom, born New York City, 1953, author of the best-selling novel Lucky Us, about a pair of teenage half-sisters who travel across World War II America in search of fame and fortune. It's the birthday of the novelist Gail Godwin, born Birmingham, 1937, author of many books, The Odd Woman, The Finishing School, The Good Husband. She was raised by her mother, who worked as a newspaper reporter and wrote romance novels on the side to try to make extra money. Godwin's grandmother did all the cleaning and cooking. Godwin later said, "Already at the age of 5, I had allied myself with the typewriter rather than the stove. The person at the stove usually had the thankless task of fueling, whereas if you were faithful to your vision at the typewriter by lunchtime, you could make 2 more characters happy, even if you weren't so happy yourself." And it was on this day in 1983 that Dr. Sally Ride became the first American woman in space aboard the Challenger for a 6-day mission. Sally Ride, who said, "The thing that I'll remember most about the flight is that it was fun. In fact, I'm sure it was the most fun I'll ever have in my life." Here's a poem for today by Barbara Crooker, Surfer Girl. I'm walking on the beach this cold, brisk morning, the bleached seagrass bending in the wind, when there up ahead in the pewter waves I see a surfer in his wetsuit, sleek as a seal, cutting in and out of the curl, shining in the light. I'm on the far side of 60, athletic as a sofa. But this is where the longing starts, the yearning for another life, the one where I'm lithe and long-limbed, tanned California bronze, short, tousled hair full of sunshine, the life where I shoulder my board, stride into the waves, dive under the breakers and rise, my head shaking off water like a golden retriever. I'm waiting for that perfect wave so I can crouch up and catch it, my arms out like wings, slicing back and forth in the froth, wind at my back, seas slick metal polished before me. Nothing more important now than this balance between water and air, the rhythm of in and out, staying ahead of the break, choosing my line like I choose these words, writing my name on water, writing my name on air." Surfer Girl, a poem by Barbara Crooker from her collection More. That's the Writer's Almanac for Thursday, June the 18th. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.